wonderful people. Welcome to yet another exciting lesson, day 3, aviation literacy 010. Previously, we learned about aviation alphabets and numerals. Just like whatever you did in nursery, trying to build A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and things like that. It's the same thing we did in the previous lesson. And today, all we are doing is just building on the previous thing that we built, trying to get our aero glossary, you know, in shape. So by and by, as and when we learn so many things about aircraft, the airports, we'll be building our glossary on the side. So that whenever you see an aircraft and there are certain parts of it, you can say, I saw this, I saw this. If you go to an airport and you see a certain area, you can say, I know this is called this, and this is how we build our literacy, just like how you built your literacy from A, B, C, D. It's so exciting. I promise to make this rather short video very exciting, very engaging. So get your pens ready, stay focused, and don't forget to like, to share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Okay? So, aviation literacy 010 day 3. What are the objectives? Objectives, as you all know, is what do we expect from you after you've listened to me for this short period? There are some things I expect. The first thing we need to do by the end of this lesson, we'll have at least 3 vocabularies and 2 terminologies. At least you are going to walk away with 3 vocabularies, that's aero vocabularies, and 2 terminologies. Okay, so when you hear some abbreviations, what do they mean? This is what we are going to do today. And so let us start right away today. We are going to look at some interesting definitions in the in our industry. And in our industry, this is the reference. As you can see, you see Dictionary of Aeronautical Terms. This is the only, or these are some of the references I must consult to give you the definition, not my own idea or paraphrase. So we are going to start right away. Are you ready? First definition, abeam. Abeam. It says a relative location, approximately right angles to the longitudinal axis of the aircraft. When an object is beside the aircraft, it is said to be abeam of it. So don't worry about all the things I read about longitudinal axis and everything. Is it to my left side? Is it to my right side? Either way, we say it is abeam. So we've learned something today. Anything to either the left or the right side of the aircraft, we say abeam. Okay, so abeam, anything to the left or the right side of an aircraft, we say, or anything to the side, that's what I mean, left or right, we say abeam. We've learned something. Let's go to 2. Aborted takeoff. Wow. I'm bringing up all these things because I'm trying to build a glossary in order of, alphabetical order, and also how you often hear these terms as you get into the industry. All you hear is an aircraft aborted takeoff. It was just when the takeoff was aborted. What does it mean? Well, I cannot tell you right off my head, but we have to consult the dictionary again. So let's look at aborted takeoff. It is a takeoff terminated prematurely when it is determined that some conditions exist which makes takeoff or further flight dangerous. Don't worry about what I mean. Just listen to the definition because I'm supposed to define it with a reference. Now I'm going to do a little bit of explanation. What I simply meant, or what the dictionary is simply saying, is that sometimes an aircraft, those of you have seen an aircraft take off either in a video or you sat in an aircraft before, what you see is that it accelerates to some point, and instead of you to look forward to getting airborne, that's being off the ground and getting into the air, next thing you hear is pow, and you hear some reducing engine sound. Then you have stopped. Then you ask yourself, what's going on? What's going on? What's going on? It's just simple. The pilot or the captain just thinks that some conditions, if I say, cropped up, which made the takeoff, you know, not desirable. Sometimes it's an indication that maybe our oil pressure is low, below limits. It could be, so many things can reject a takeoff. Even sometimes a car just crossing in front of us in the runway. Even a cow, I've done it before myself, where you have to abort a takeoff because a car was just crossing the runway to the other side and stuff like that. So any condition that makes takeoff not desirable, the captain has to abort the takeoff. So you hear things like aborted takeoff. So it's a condition that doesn't make takeoff, safe. And in the captain's judgment, he has to abort the takeoff and deal with the issue. So going to the next one, which is accelerate. I'm sure you've heard it in cars. If those of you have sat in vehicles, seen racing cars on Formula One and everything, you hear this word accelerate, accelerate. What does it mean? So accelerate is to increase the speed of an object or make it move faster. So when you sit in a car, you can feel some acceleration that is now going faster than when you sat in the car initially, what speed it was doing. Aircrafts also have it. Accelerate. We use it for so many things. An aircraft is about to take off. What do you see it doing? It's accelerating to a point, meaning that it's just changing its speed or increasing its speed. So we have a beam, we have aborted takeoff, we have accelerate. Is it getting exciting? Let's move on. Okay, so our next definition is banking or bank, whichever way is the same thing. Banking, bank. And I know when I say bank, certain things come to mind already. A place where you go to save your money or withdraw. But in aviation, it's a totally different term. Or in physics, it's a totally different term. So let's see what the reference says. The reference says, to rotate an airplane about its longitudinal axis or tilt its wings by using the ailerons. Don't worry about the thick words and the jargons, etc. I'll simplify it. An airplane is turned by banking it. So simply put, when an aircraft turns to the left or the right, it is banking, full stop. The reason we say this is that now that you are building your aero glossary, you don't stand anywhere and say, I saw the aircraft turning Jesus left, I saw it turning right. No, now you know. That's why we are building our glossary. Now you know, we just say the aircraft banked to the left or maybe banked to the right. Longitudinal axis is just simple. I mean, it's an axis down the aircraft, which is like this. So whether you are doing left or right, you are moving around what we call a longitudinal axis. But forget about that. For your stage now, when an aircraft turns left or right, we say it is banking. So the next one we're looking at, we are now on the seaside, and we're looking at carbon. Carbon. So let's look at our reference. What does the reference say? It says, the portion of an aircraft structure in which passengers ride. Guess what? If you have a flight to catch and you just enter the aircraft, guess where you have been? You have just entered the cabin, simply put. So it's a portion of an aircraft structure where the passengers ride. So you are in the cabin. Passengers are in the cabin. So are we making some progress? Today we've learned about five of them. A beam, aborted takeoff, accelerate, bank, and cabin. We'll just do about two or three terminologies and we'll be done for the day. And the first one we're looking out of the two is AMT. And because of your previous lesson, I'm not going to say AMT again. I'm going to say alpha dot mike dot tango. AMT. It just simply means aviation maintenance technician. Okay? These are the professionals who really service our aircrafts and make them ready and safe for us to fly. The aviation maintenance technicians. Some people call it aircraft maintenance technicians. Same thing for this definition. And the last one we'll hear of is aviation medical examiner. That is Alpha Mike Echo. So Alpha Mike Echo is aviation medical examiner. And the reason I brought this up is that they are the first people you will meet ever when you come into this career. These are the people who understand the fitness of any aviation professional and make sure that you match up to that fitness. So that's where you go for your first fitness test, and he will tell you, and he will be guiding you all throughout your career in the industry. He is going to tell you, or she is going to tell you, how to keep the standards. So aviation medical examiner. So to summarize, aviation maintenance technician and aviation medical examiner. So thank you all for being with me today, and we'll take a last recap and we are dismissed for the day. So a beam, anything to the side of the aircraft, we say it's a beam. We got that one. Aborted takeoff, conditions that don't make takeoff safe or continued flight safe. You stop the takeoff because certain things are not safe for continued takeoff. Accelerate, increasing the speed of an object, or in this case, increasing the speed of an aircraft. And the next thing is banking. When an aircraft turns either to the left side or to the right side, we say it is banking, not turning. So after this lesson, as we build our glossaries, do remember to say banking. Then the next one is carbon. That is the aircraft structure, the portion of the aircraft structure where we, the passengers, or you, the passengers, reside. It's called the cabin. Then we quickly went into a bit of terminologies or abbreviations. And that's the aviation maintenance technician. They are responsible for servicing the aircrafts and putting it in a safe form for us to fly. Then we looked at aviation medical examiner, Alpha Mike Echo. And these are the guys who guide you to be fit according to the industry standards in order to fly the aircraft safely. I've enjoyed you so much. Thank you so much. And we'll meet on the next lesson.